Always a favourite on every rural road. Hyundai Country Calendar.
Theirs is a lifestyle made of milk and honey.
It's brilliant, and you get an amazing product at the end of the day.
They're creating a sustainable business that's all about hard work and sacrifice.
You do feel like the harder you work, the luckier you are.
A family turning a rural dream into reality. Early summer in rural Waikato has brought a perfect day for Rory O'Brien and his bees.
We've come over to Pōra today to check our hives over here. This is one of the first sites that I ever had. If one area has quite a rough spring, like we have done with the West Coast, it's great to have hives in different parts of the Waikato that hopefully have more settled weather. I grew up in the area here and getting into beekeeping, just looking for places, and really lucky with these guys. They came on board and let me put hives here from the start, and it's been brilliant. Days like this, you could hardly call it work. It surprised me how much I enjoyed working with the bees. They're brilliant creatures that fascinate me. Every day I'm learning something new. They're really kind. A lot of people think bees got hot thumbs and they sting you a fair bit, but no, they're fine, they're really gentle. Beekeeping is quite brilliant like that. When you open that lid of a hive, you completely focus on that task and what that hive needs, and it's all about giving them everything that they need so they can do their thing. It's just good to see how the bees are going as well. Are they filling up the frames? And are they drawing up the foundation that I have? These are permanent beehives. I don't move my hives around too much at all. I'm not really a migratory beekeeper as such. So these bees are able to pollinate this whole area year round on the different flowers that bloom at different times of the year. It's kinder on the bees. You're not moving them around from site to site, so they're pretty well established here. You're not trucking them around and beating them up on the road.
Rory's family business is called the Hunt and Gather Bee Company. The name reflects his love of the work, which takes him to secret spots all over Waikato.
I love being out and about in the backcountry. I get to travel around and work and look at flowers all day. You get pretty in tune with what's happening in the bush, and that's a big part of why I enjoy it. I love it. It's a little bit of an adventure every time you go into one of the sites in the backcountry. Yeah, a little bit of forward driving keeps my day interesting. We've come to take the Rewerewa honey off, which has all finished flowering now, and the bees should be bringing in the kānuka now. Things are looking good. It's flowering well. I'm looking forward to it.
The road towards that perfect lifestyle hasn't always been smooth for the O'Briens. 6 years ago, life for Rory and his wife Hannah was rather different.
We were contract milking on a farm on the Coromandel Peninsula, and it was a tough farm, it was a tough job, and there was a moment where Hannah came up to me one milking and said she was pregnant with our firstborn. And I'll always remember that, and that was at the moment when I decided that we needed to make a change.
Rory was the hardest working person that I know, and he would be working massive hours, and you know, there's always that thing that you have to be back for milking every afternoon, and he sometimes would, like during calving, doing it by himself, he was exhausted.
I think dairy farming is one of the hardest jobs in the country. It has a massive toll on you. We were running an operation ourselves, so sole charge, contract milking, so there's a lot of stress coming from different angles and you're sleep deprived, and it's a lot of mental hard work as well. So yeah, there came a point where I just needed a change. So we took a bit of a hit financially and just looked at the bigger picture.
We're always going to do something agriculture-based. Like, we'd really loved farming. We'd had an awesome 7 years farming. But just in the long term, you know, farm ownership wasn't probably going to be on the cards for us.
The steps in the ladder to farm ownership through dairy farming had changed a fair bit over the years. So the carrot was quite far away from my nose. They're really calm. They have a honey flow happening right now, so they're more occupied with that and what's happening with that than wanting to attack me. Bees in general are just gentle creatures, so nothing to be worried about here.
There are a few crucial months when beekeepers have to keep a close eye on the state of their hives. In spring, many feed a sugar syrup to their bees, but Rory is trying to do things differently. He boosts his hives with a smorgasbord of nutrients to prepare his bees for the summer months ahead.
We've noticed a lot of Nosema serranae, which is a gut parasite, which affects the bees. By giving them the Agrisea seaweed, it's helping clean them out and improving that gut biology. There's not that much flowering out around here, around the bush, so we need to step in and supplement them to make sure that they are strong and healthy heading into the honey flow.
It's an important job. If they don't get it right now, their year's work will be in vain.
Sugar syrup alone is a straight carbohydrate, so we want to add those aminos, those important nutrients, to give our bees the best chance we can.
The calm and tranquility of Raglan Harbour on the North Island's west coast. It's home base for beekeeper Rory O'Brien. He's out and about on rural roads every day, visiting each hive at least once a fortnight.
I swear this road's getting rougher, eh? So when it comes to sites, usually it's word of mouth, often just chance encounters with people and talking to people out on the road. And yeah, when you already know a landowner prior to having the hives on, you have quite a good sort of friendship there already.
This site is owned by a friendly farmer. It takes a bit for Rory and his trusty ute to get there.
It's well off the road, which is a good thing, close to the native bush, so it ticks a lot of boxes, good food sources available, and security for the bees. One of the first things I fell in love with was that I could work in the outdoors. I'm getting to go out into some amazing, hard-to-reach places and into wild places, which I really enjoy. And then you're working with such an incredible critter that is bringing in such a fantastic product. You know, it's a really healthy, natural product out of the hills, and they're doing such a positive effect on the environment around them at the same time. The bees have been unable to get out and forage as much as they should have over the spring period, so they haven't been able to build up quite as nicely as what I had hoped. They missed out on a bit of that early nectar flow, but seem to be working okay now.
Rory harvests a wide range of bush honey. In this part of Waikato, kānuka is popular with the bees.
It's just what surrounds us. We don't have a lot of mānuka over here, and there's some great things with kānuka. It's a fantastic plant. It's been quite a gold rush with the mānuka. There's been a lot of focus on that, so there's been a lot of cowboys out there, as you get with other things when there's such a value on it. So it's been a bit ugly at times. The other varieties have sort of been forgotten about in this hype that there is around the Mānuka. Mānuka is a fantastic product, but there is more to New Zealand honeys than just Mānuka.
While Rory is hunting and gathering in the bush, wife Hannah is back home making beeswax wraps. They're a nice addition to the family honey business.
We've had to employ someone from Raglan to come out and help me make them because I just couldn't keep up with the demand for them. They're so popular. So it's more a matter of trying to keep them in stock, really.
Hannah recently got a boost from winning the Rural Women Emerging Business Award.
We've learnt just to keep going. You know, just keep going. If you know that you're doing a good thing and you're doing it ethically and you're doing it the way you want to do it and it's working, just I think that was the most encouraging thing, just keep going. Eventually it'll make some money. Just good to know that even though, you know, financially we weren't really there, the choices that we'd made early on were working out and we were kind of doing things the right way.
With Rory spending long hours away from the family, Hannah loves the freedom of working from home and spending time with children, Kieran and Alice.
I'm not much of a gardener, but I really love it. You know, the kids like to come in here.
I found heaps. I found a snail.
That means we can grow a good part of our food, which is awesome for us.
Good ones.
Being pregnant, Hannah's keeping as far away from the bees as possible. A close encounter a couple of years ago gave Hannah a bit of a scare.
When I was about 8.5 months pregnant with Alice, I got stung by a bee, and I hadn't been stung since I was a kid. And yeah, within about 10 minutes, I was sneezing and covered in a rash and starting to have trouble breathing. It was pretty scary, especially with being pregnant and they didn't quite know what was going to happen, giving me an adrenaline shot when I was, you know, they thought it could put me into labour. They said to me at the hospital, oh, well, you know, you're just going to have an EpiPen and just stay away from beehives. I said, well, funny story, we just bought all these beehives. But I did get stung a couple of times last summer when I wasn't pregnant and I was okay. So I think it's more of one of those great things that happens when you're pregnant.
Come here.
Really special to us seeing the kids being part of this lifestyle that we've chosen, and you know, they love it. Nice way to bring up our kids, I think. How's that look?
Good.
Okay, one more.
One more to go.
I just think it gives them a healthier understanding of what food is and what they're eating and what it takes to put together a meal.
They can really learn that food is just proper food, eh?
It is proper food, yep, that's right.
So they can learn that as well.
You can learn what's proper food, yep, that's right.
Do you remember that, Ellie? Mm-hmm. We weren't in a tent, we were in a hut. What colour was the hut?
Orange.
Bright orange, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah,
the
beehives.
When night falls and the kids are all tucked in, it's not unusual to find Rory and Hannah back working in the shed.
Here I am wiring one of our wooden frames. We choose to go with wood. It was a decision we made early on when we started our beekeeping. We're just trying to reduce the amount of plastic that we're using in our operation. So it means a fair bit more time and it costs a bit more money, but I sleep better at night.
when we're working in the shed and you look outside and it's dark and you realise it's 10 o'clock at night, you do feel like the harder you work, the luckier you are, really. It does feel like we're doing it for ourselves, not for someone else.
This shed holds a lot of history for the young family. Rory and Hannah lived here with their children for the first 2 years of the business.
We have big goals in mind from the start, and so it takes a bit of a sacrifice. Once we bought the land out here and we put a shed on it, the obvious decision was to come and live in the shed just to make things work. It sounds worse than it is, but it's pretty comfortable. It wasn't too bad to live in 36 square metres with two children for 2 years. Yeah, we're happy, like, it was enjoyable and we'll always remember that, the kids will remember it.
There was a bit of pioneering perseverance that got Rory and Hannah through those early stages. They wanted to stay true to their environmental philosophies, even if it meant doing without.
A couple of times we've driven to the market with the petrol light on empty to make enough money to put gas in the car to drive home. But it's just part of those early days, and it was definitely character building, but I think it's made us much more determined in the long run that this will work, because we've invested everything financially and so much time, and we really love
well.
It. So it will be successful, because it has to be.
Yeah, we don't have a plan B, which is kind of the key.
Yeah.
Plan B, plan A doesn't work. So yeah, we've put everything into this, and it makes you grit through those tough times when you have that.
The Red Devon cattle grazing at Rory's parents' Raglan farm seem oblivious to the first day of a new tourism venture underway right next door.
So yeah, just remember to not stand in front of them, but I'll go and give...
We really wanted to be able to show people what we do, but in a way that's just small groups, they can get hands on, they can get right in there and see how it is in real life.
All right, so we'll take that one off. Big fat thighs there, it's
beautiful. Whoa! So much heavier than the ones before.
It's nice to be able to bring people out and give them an experience that they probably wouldn't have otherwise. It's not every day you get to do this, you know, put on a suit and go through a beehive with someone.
Away from the hives, Michael and Jean O'Brien are enjoying their semi-retirement. They've found a practical way to help out the family.
They're doing as much as they can to start a business up, and we're here to support them, and having our property close by just gives them another avenue which they can exploit, and I think it's great. Gives me something to do. His level of communication, his ability to talk to all people, I think it's great. He's doing a really good job. I admire him.
So how was it? What did you guys think?
So cool.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Learned some new stuff?
Yeah, I knew nothing about bees.
After a long, hot summer harvest, Rory now has to get their honey out of the hives and into glass jars.
How you going?
Good, mate. Compliments of the season.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Yeah, getting there, right. It's all good.
This is the extraction plant in Katikati.
Awesome. Heavy boxes?
Yeah, I got some solid ones here for you and the boys. So, yeah,
awesome.
Well choked
awesome.
Out, so that's good. Yeah.
Dave Hayes is a long-time kiwifruit grower and beekeeper. He and his wife Julie set up BNZ 5 years ago. They export their own honey and work with other beekeepers in the district to process and package their products. Today, they're extracting Rory's Kānuka honey.
That's exciting stuff. You know, we've got to the end of our season and these are the rewards, and the bees have done a marvellous job, and it's exciting to see, and watching it all flow out of the frames and then into the vats. It's brilliant. It's what we've been waiting for all summer.
He Here we go, Rory. Here's your Kanuka.
Cool. Is this me here, is it?
It is. We just packed this week, so your 500 gram and your 1 kilo jars.
Awesome. Yeah, no, that'll be fantastic. Start getting it out there.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
Happy customers. Let's go grab a forklift.
Fantastic.
Dave and Julie have watched Rory and Hannah grow their business over the last 5 years. They've been mentors in beekeeping and in business.
They have a great story. They know their why, and they're very passionate about what they do. Kanuka seems to be the next kid on the block. It has proven anti-inflammatory properties, so you're seeing it being used now in skincare. It's also a great tasting honey. So for those that possibly their Manuka has a higher dollar point, the Kanuka is an equally yummy tasting honey with some really good health benefits. And it's out there. It's out there on the shelf. It's becoming more and more popular.
Back home, there's a sense of permanence here. Rory and Hannah are keen to create a lifestyle and a business that is sustainable and well-principled.
That's it. Nailed it.
We are a part of the new kind of generation of agriculture. We've decided on the lifestyle that we want, and then we've made the business work around that. So, you know, the kids come first, and the ethics behind our business come first, and then the finances and the other parts of the business just work around that.
I think we've found that money isn't everything. We definitely, early on in our careers, we were chasing the dollars, looking for that big share milking job or anything like that. But there came a time where you got to get that balance right for your well-being and your family's well-being as a whole. You got to enjoy this life, and it's that old cliche of find a job you love and you never have to work another day in your life, and it's... I think we've done it.
Calendar was brought to you by Hyundai New Zealand.